we're looking at my 2000 Jeep Cherokee XJ 4-liter. I just changed the water pump, thermostat housing. There's lots of videos on YouTube to show you how to do that. But what I wanted to show you today is kind of taking the next step to finish this off. I'm going to replace top radiator, bottom radiator hose, and both heater hoses, which connect to the heater core over here, with silicone hoses. And you know, rather than replace the leaky hoses that I had that were brittle and dried out, probably baked from all the heat that comes from these engines, decided to replace the water pump and a bunch of other stuff, but wanted to go to a hose that's maybe will last longer. So for the heater hose, I'm using this hose that's made by a company called Flexfab. You know, on your Jeep, you're going to have two different sizes for the heater hose. You're going to have a 5/8 and a 3/4. I got 3 feet of each. You can see on here the part numbers. I ordered these on eBay. There's several sellers that sell it by the foot. And 3 feet in each size should be more than enough. These are embossed clamps, and on the perimeter of the clamp, the gears that the clamp tightens on are just embossed. They're not cut all the way through the clamp, so there's no holes in the clamp that will dig in and bite through your softer silicone hoses. On your Jeep, the bottom hose is the smaller of the two hoses. Alright, so we had to cut our hose to length. I'm just going to kind of snug up these hose clamps. Not super tight, but just kind of get everything in position. Now, these hoses aren't molded to the shape that the factory ones were, so we're going to have to kind of play with that a little bit just to get them to kind of stay out of the way of other stuff in the engine compartment. But so that's snug. I'm not going to make it super tight yet. Replacing these hose clamps is kind of nice because the factory hose clamps are those ones that you have to squeeze, and honestly kind of a pain to get off. These will be really easy if they ever need to be serviced again. Alright, so we're putting on the second hose. Just kind of push it all the way on. One of our hose clamps back there so that we can zip tie that up later. And then this guy has to route under all of this throttle linkage stuff. And come around and holds in here. You can see we're going to have some excess hose, so we're going to have to make a cut. A little block of wood here that I'm going to use to cut on, just using a razor blade. And I think right about here was where I wanted to be. Try and cut as straight as we can. Too bad. Just a few extra inches on this hose. Get our other hose clamp on the end. And we'll push this guy down onto the thermostat housing. that's snug. I'll probably tighten it just a little bit more than that. But no. So as you can see, I've got my hose clamps already on the top radiator hose on both sides, actually. And I'm just going to try and work this guy down onto the thermostat housing. Actually goes on pretty easily. And we may have to twist that a little bit to get it to line up, but that's a good fit there. And then we've got, sorry, I'm hitting the camera. Got my overflow hose here, and we're gonna try and hook this guy in. So we've got the top radiator hose in. You can see the band and contour of it looks pretty close to factory. Factory hose had like a little plastic sheath around it that was kind of chewed up. I could put it back on there, but it's not actually rubbing on anything, so I think I'll probably leave it as is. I did zip tie my top heater hose in to this, just not super tight, but just to kind of keep everything under control. So far, looks really clean. Everything's nice and snug. Got to do the bottom hose now. So I've got the bottom hose on. Actually, the fit is pretty good. It bends as it bends down around. Goes under these pulleys. Conforms nicely. Comes up, snug up onto the water pump. I'd have to say I'm really pleased with the fit. So again, I'll leave the links in the description. But now I just got to work on getting the hose clamps on into a position where I can reach them again if I ever need to take these off. So we got the hoses all done. Bottom hose was a little challenging because I had to get under the car to get the hose clamp in a position that wasn't going to potentially obstruct the serpentine belt or make contact with the serpentine belt. You can see I'm connected down here on the bottom of the radiator. Got everything replaced. Looks really good. So now I just got to get my new serpentine belt on and get some fluids in it. Put the fan shroud back on, put the electric fan back in, and then we'll be in business. But overall, I'm really happy with the install. The hoses from HPS, pretty nice. Really good fit and finish. And should be able to count on the cooling system for a long time. So I hope this helps you. Take a look at my other videos. Feel free to leave comments. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.